Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see what is Cloudflare Images and how to set up and use it. The Cloudflare Images is a single product that store, resize, optimize and serve the images to different channels. In most of the cases, we need to deliver different variants, example size and formats of the images to different channel. This is handled by creating different image variants and storing them in a server through workflow or even to CDN. But this creates more overhead to create, store, and retrieve the images. The image CDNs help here. The variants to the images can be easily created through the image CDN. Upload the original image, then create the required variants on CDN. There are different image CDNs available. Another example is Fastly CDN. Maybe we can see that in another video. The Cloudflare Images was recently introduced. This can be accessed through Cloudflare console. So you can click here, Images. It will take you to the Cloudflare CDN Images. The Images option is only available for enterprise or subscription-based customers. And it is not available for free-tier customers. You can see here the different pricing details. Resizing is free. You can create up to 20 variants. The next one is storage. $5 per 100K images per month. Only paid for the original image. It means not for the variants. Here the payment is prepaid. You can select the different storage options based on your project storage need. Next one is delivery. $1 per 100K images served. Here the payment is postpaid based on the usage. Let me click continue here. Here select the storage options based on your project need. So as we discussed, $5 per month, 100K images, or you can go with different options. Also you can go with custom. So here you can select the required capacity. You can add 1, 2 or 3 based on, 1 means like 100K images. You can add the custom storage capacity here. Let me select the basic storage, 100K images, click on continue. Now you should be providing your billing details. After entering the billing details, you can click on purchase. Once the subscription is enabled, you can use the quick upload or the API to upload the images to CDN. Here you can drop the images or click to browse. Let me browse for an image. Select this. Yeah, the image is uploaded now. You can find the standard, the image delivery URL here, the imagedelivery.net, then the ID, then image ID and variant name. The default variant name is public. Let me now click on preview. So you can find the preview URL here. Copy this. So let me go here and put it. So you can see here the image ID and the public as the variant name. So if I access this, you will be getting the actual image. So now let me go back. So close this. If I want to edit it, I can click on edit. So you can see here the image ID, you can copy this image ID. Also the curl command to access the image. Then if you want to delete, you can delete. The variants, right now only public is enabled, we can talk about that. Then you can copy the image URL. Then even you can select require signed URLs, maybe we can talk about that too. So if I click, it will become a signed, like user should be signed in to access this specific image. Let us now see how to get the image details through API, means the curl command. So this is the curl command. Let me copy this. So let me paste it here. If you see here, we need a authorization token, means bearer token. So it's connecting to the API, api.cloudflare.com. Then with the image detail, this is the image ID. Let's generate that. For that, I'm going into again cloudflare.com. Click on your account. So here you can see API tokens. So let me generate a token, create token. You can use the API token templates, what exists, but I am going with custom because I am going to enable only the access for images. So get started. I'm saying image access. Now account, that's fine. Here you select the images, Cloudflare images, that's fine. I am giving read access. If required, you can give edit access too. So then all accounts, fine. If you want to restrict with IP address, client IP address, you can do that. So then continue to summary, create token. Yeah, now the token is generated, copy this. So here replace with API token. Now if I go to this, enter, I'm getting the JSON response. If you see here the file name, download.png, then the image ID, when it was uploaded, require signed in URLs, it's false because we did not enable that. Then this is the public URLs, the variants URL. Yes, HTTPS, image delivery.net, then image ID, then the public. This one you can directly access through curl command. So if I copy, if you have multiple variants, all those variants are listed here. So if I do this, and say output, maybe download.png. Yeah, it's downloaded now. Let us now see how to configure different variants. Let me click on variants. If you see here, the default public variant is configured. Let me edit it. You can see different configurations, the sizing options, width and height, also fit. You can select different parameters here, scale down, contain, cover, crop, pad. We can see what are those means. Another one is metadata. The default is strip all metadata, means all the metadatas are removed for the delivery. You can select different options, strip all except copyright, also keep all metadata. Even you can select always allow public access. This overrides the image level access control, means even though image is set as require signed in URL, by this configuration, the image can be accessed publicly. You can create up to 20 variants. Let me go back to variants. So if you see here, you can add test. So let me add new variant, change the sizing options, fit, then metadata, even public access. So I'm going and saving. Let me go to images now. Images, if I come to this preview, you can see here the public variant. Now it's one of two. Now if I click next, you can see this test variant is created for the existing images also. Now I can copy this, so I can just access this image. Now let me go back. So if I want to edit this, edit it. If you come down, you can see two variants now. Variants like public, then the variants test. Quickly access through curl command. So if I access this again, so this one. Yeah, you can see two variants. The public variant and test variant is in the response. If you want even, you can delete the variants. Refer to this URL for more details on variants fit property. So we discuss about fit property while configuring the variant. You can see the more options here. The scale down, contain, cover, crop and pad. The details on those options. Let us now quickly see how to use the API to upload or delete the images. So let me go to use API. So now if you see here, there is a curl command. You can copy this and use this to upload the images. Earlier you uploaded the images through this quick upload UI. Now we can use this API. So for this, as a first step, we need to set up the API token. So let me go into this. Even you can click on this account, my profile, then API tokens. So earlier token, what we setup is read-only, means only to read the images, but even you can update this token. So edit this token and update with additional access. But I am going to create new token. Create token, again same steps. Get started, I will say maybe image management. Then select the permissions. I am going with image. This fine, then I am going and saying edit. Then continue to summary, create the token. This is fine. Now let me go back here, this one. I will copy this curl command. Then I will go here. So let me paste it. Here I need the bearer token. Let me copy from here. This is fine, the API token. And I'm going to upload a file with the name download1.jpg. This fine, copy this. If I go here, paste it. Yeah, now if you see the image is uploaded successfully, ID, then file name, then variants, two variants. If you go back to this UI, you can see the new image. Images, yeah, you can see download1.jpg. The same details you can find it here also. Let me now delete a image. So for that, go into this URL, delete images. So this is the API command. So just let me copy this. So go here again. Okay, now I need this bearer token here. Same token I can copy. This is fine. Now I need this account ID and image ID should be replaced. So for that, maybe I will go here. The account ID can be copied from here. The account ID under images. So let me copy this. So this is fine. Account ID replaced here. Now I need the image ID. For that again, I will go to this images, download one. I'm going to use this, edit it. So this is the image ID. Copy this, then replace this with the image ID. This is fine now. Go and execute this. Yeah, now if you see success equal to true means successfully the image is deleted. So if I go back here, again images, yeah, you can see the image is deleted now. There are more operations can be performed through this API. Refer to this URL for more details. So even you can upload an image, we've seen that. You can update the image, even metadata can be updated. If I go to this update image, you can see even you can pass the metadata, additional metadata, then list images, image details, delete we have seen, then image usage statistics, even you can perform operation on variants, delete, list, create, even the image keys, that we can see it later. You can perform various operations through these APIs. Let us now see how to create signed in private image URLs. This enables only specific set of people to access the image. So as a first step, let me edit this image. If you see here, there is an option require signed URLs. Let me click on that. This is fine. Let me save it. Okay, fine now. Now if I go to preview and copy this, so this will require the signature, insert signed token. So this is the base URL. Now let's see how to generate this signed token. So one option is like, maybe you can go here, this URL using signed URL tokens. So this is a worker, sample worker. You can just copy this. I'm going to create this worker. Now if you go back here, post this workers, create a service. So I'm going with the same default. Now create a service. So now quick edit, I'm pasting this. This is fine. Save and deploy. Yeah, this is fine. Now what we can do is we'll go back here. Just I copy this URL till here, public. Now go back. Just to keep it here, slash this fine, send. Yeah, I got the final signature based URL. So I will copy this URL, then come here, I'll put it here. So if you see your signature, other one is expire. So what time this asset will be expired. So I will show you that if I do. Yeah, I did a mistake. So what one more step we need to do here, there is a key from images dashboard. We need to copy and configure this. Yeah, if I go to images, now come to this keys, display and copy this key, come back. If I paste it here, this fine now, save. Save and deploy, this fine, now send it. Now I got the new one, copy this. I go here, access, I should be able to access the image now. There is another one is expire. The default value is 1 day. So you can change it whatever the way you want. So this is one way. So you can use this worker to generate this URL, signed URL. Otherwise, even you can generate the token by own. So if you see here, I am using some free service here. So you need to just to provide this URL, content path URL. Let me do that maybe. I do this, copy this. Now if I come here and paste it, it's fine. This is my token secret key.
Now I'm computing. This is fine. Paste it here. Yeah, I'm able to access the image. So because the expire I did not calculate it, so I just removed that. Otherwise, I'm able to. Just for demo, I am using this public service, but ensure the token is protected. Same way, you can use other libraries to generate the signed image URL. Even you can copy this URL. So whatever the URL be generated, so copy this. Let me go here, paste it. So same thing, the base URL, the worker URL, then the image URL, the image base URL without the sign-in token. So just enter. You will get this image signed URL. So now I should be able to access the image. Yeah. Let us now see another scenario, direct creator upload. It means this feature lets your users upload images with a one-time upload URL. So if your end user want to upload some image in your app or website, so you can use this feature. By using direct creator upload, you can accept uploads without exposing your API key or token to the client. Let us now see how to request for a one-time upload URL. You can go here, refer to this page, direct creator upload, direct creator upload. This is the curl command. You can use this to retrieve the one-time upload URL. So I copied this here. So you should be changing this bearer token, then the account ID. By default, the upload URL expires after 30 minutes. But you can override this by specifying this parameter, expiry, the data. So you can specify minimum of 2 minutes or maximum of 6 hours. The time is in GMT. You can specify based on your need. Let me execute this curl command now. Copy this. Let me go here. Paste. It's fine. Yeah, now you can get this upload URL. Just copy this. It's fine. Now if I go back here, just created a HTML page. Then I'm replacing this upload URL here. It's fine. Remaining all fine. This is a simple form. Now let me go here. Refresh this. This is fine. Choose the file. I'm going with this file. Click submit. Yeah. Now fine. You're getting the response, variance and all those details. Let me go back here. Yeah, you can see this download 1.jpg is uploaded now. Even the image can be uploaded to the one-time upload URL through curl or other clients. Let me create a one-time upload URL again. So let me copy this and execute. Okay, I got a one-time upload URL. Let me copy this. Fine. I'm going to use this curl command, post, then file, image.png, then bearer token, then the one-time URL. So I'm replacing this. Let me copy this. It's fine. If I come back here, yeah, now it's uploaded successfully. Let me go back here, select the images again. Yeah, I can see the image.png also. Some of the important highlights of Cloudflare images are variant and different formats are not counted for storage quota. Next one is images can be marked as private. So it can be only accessed using an expiring signed URL token. Multiple ways to upload your images through UI, quick upload, APIs, or even direct creator upload. Upload through one-time upload URLs. This accepts all the common file formats including JPEG, GIF, PNG and WebP. The file size, the upload file size can be up to 10 MB. That's all for today. We have seen what is Cloudflare images and how to set up and use it. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.